a lot of this stuff, we're gonna tack this bill on to the movie company. It's not really gonna hurt us. You know, so we'll be bringing on a few extra people on board, which we'll get a chance to get caught up in a couple other things over there. You know, so that's gonna help out. We're looking at trying to get call-off letters sent off on Monday to everybody else. So, you know, come Monday, we'll, you know, that stuff will go out, you know. And other than that, we're, you know, we'll look, you know, getting eager to get started, you know, and see what comes out of it, you know. We got the big issue that, you know, till the trestle's done, well, you know, that is a, you know, that sort of puts a hinder on our, on what's gonna happen this summer, because we have to see it done before we can really tackle it.
Is Mr. Kacharis, who you referenced in there, is he with the FRA for my own application?
Okay.
So we're all up to
good.
Yeah. And I talked to him yesterday.
And I forgot to tell Mr. Salazar, but Mr. Gutierrez told me yesterday that he will not be able to make it next year because he's got some personal commitments.
He's got what now?
His personal commitments next week, so he can't be here.
Okay. Any questions? Commissioner Randall?
Marvin, could you clarify for me the how much we anticipate the cost of the FRA required running gear work per locomotive, or does it vary? I mean, I'm sure it varies a little bit depending on what you find, but if we were budgeting a cost to do that running gear work, which we're coming up to requiring it on all the locomotives, how much should we be looking at per loco?
It's all gonna depend on what you have to, you know, what you have to work with.
Right.
You know, locomotive running gears tend to wear uneven. And depending on what part wears off, there's a different cost to it. Like right now, we're having to redo a number one axle on the 484. So, you know, that's added services because we can't press that ourselves. That's got to get shipped out to get pressed out and then brought back. We'll make the axle and then we'll send it back out to get it repressed. You know, so there's added cost here and there. To give you a definite figure, I cannot give you one because I don't have one. We're working on what it's going to cost us to finish 487. When we get done with the 487, we should be able to come up with that. Because we did the same thing to the 487.
To budget, we've got to come up with some average number that we budget. So you think through the work on the 487 and the 484, we'll be able to come up with that for at least the other two?
Yes, I think so. I think we're going to be very close.
Any idea of scope? 100 and a half?
I'm going to say about 125 to 130.
125 to 130.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. That would be with at least one maybe unexpected component to it. Thank you, sir. Uh-huh.
Any other questions? Okay.
Great job on the budget control.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Norm. Marketing report.
Well, as we've all discussed and we're aware of, due to the Lovato trestle fire, we're facing a pretty unique and a challenge for marketing for this season. The biggest challenge we have to face right now is just continued misperception and misinformation that something, you know, we're still not operating, something may be wrong. So we're going to be addressing that through everything we're doing this year, public relations, marketing, advertising, everything. And our fully integrated approach, we really feel is going to be a big added, you know, asset to us. The preseason, everything we've done since the end of last season has been real positive. Things are going really well. We're happy to report that on the books versus year ago, 2010, we're up approximately 20% versus year ago. And that's being driven primarily by group sales, which is really good to see that coming back, as it is a piece of our business. Importantly, the key markets that we need to go after, obviously we're international, we're national, but New Mexico, Colorado, and Texas, those are our top three markets. So as we look at what we're going to be doing this year, those three markets will have, you know, extra emphasis. Our objective, Elmer stated, is 40,000 plus riders this year, and that's to get us back to 2009 level. But within that, it's important to note that we need to go up in New Mexico, We need to go up in Colorado, and we need to go up in Texas ridership. And we're going to be working really hard to accomplish those goals. Our action plan is to communicate across all marketing channels that the Cumbres and Toltec is back and bigger than ever. That's critical. We have to let people know that, you know, it's back, we're bigger, we're better than we've ever been before. And our new ad campaign will communicate that. We're going to recommending an increased electronic media spend in our key local markets of New Mexico and Colorado. And I'll speak about that in just a couple minutes here. And again, everything we're doing is to keep reinforcing that the railroad is fine, it's back. One important thing we're going to do this year we've never done before is what's called a video news release. We'll be videotaping when we're ready, and this is in conjunction making sure that everything's in time with Leo, Marvin, Elmer, to make sure that the trestle is in fact ready to go. When it is, we'll be releasing a video with copy points written by Mr. Hume here that will go to all the TV stations in New Mexico, Colorado, Texas, Oklahoma, all of our drive markets. What we're hoping there is that it'll make the news. Slow news day, if they're looking for something to talk about with regards to the upcoming summer season, the hopes then will be that those news stations will send reporters out so that they'll actually cover the story and make it an even bigger story than we initially hoped for. The other component that's critical is our new website. Very shortly, we encourage all of you to go check it out. The biggest thing there was to make it easier to use and to actually sell tickets. It's not supposed to be a museum site. It's supposed to work. And you'll notice that on every page, we have a calendar to be able to actually go in, check availability for seats and tickets, and actually book a trip. So it's going to be just like Budget, American Airlines, United, a hotel, and that's critical to us selling more tickets this year. Okay, what we're proposing this year is our normal plan of permanence and presence for international and national markets, but then overlaid with that will be television, radio, and timely PR releases, as well as newspaper and print where needed. But this year, we're proposing something completely different. We need to get the $40,000 that we're asking for as a budget increase. We need to get New Mexico back up to a level where we were in 2009, 2010 for opening day through the end of June. What we did because of the fire was moved a lot of our funding that we would have used for this opening day back into last season to try and get our numbers up. We ended up doing about 29,000 last year versus 40. So obviously we all know about the downturn, but we've got to get that back up. So we're proposing getting our New Mexico spend back up on two key broadcast stations out of Albuquerque reaching the entire state. We also have a plan with PBS Channel 5. Due to a fundraiser we did last year, we discovered that public television is our audience. 50 plus, affluent, they're interested in history, they're interested in travel, so that's an important fact for us. But here's what we're proposing. Public television called Rocky Mountain PBS. We can reach the entire state of Colorado for our entire season on all PBS stations. That'll be 5.2 million impressions across the season. And this will be part of our incremental spend. Secondly, Texas. We're going to finally go into Texas with television on PBS. The markets of Austin, Amarillo, Killeen, Waco, and Lubbock with 2 million impressions. And again, that would run for the course of the season. So our plan is, once again, to take our new campaign. If you've seen the new trip guide, we've already launched this campaign. It's clean, it's powerful, shows one of our assets, which is our machinery, talks about our history, and we're going to get that done. We'll be shooting our new TV commercial within the next couple weeks. And again, because of our media spend with Channel 7 down in Albuquerque, they've actually agreed to help us produce the spot in their studios at no charge to us. So that's where we're at, gentlemen. And any questions, I look forward to you know, helping get this passed.
Yeah, thank you, Chris. Can you define for the commission? I know we talked about finding a way to come up with an extra $40,000 to put into. I know we had 40,000 riders and 29 last year, and now 40,000 is the new up, obviously.
Yeah.
Flat is the new up, I guess.
Basically, the way we look at it is, if you want to look at it in raw numbers, 40,000 riders, our budget is, you know, if we try to spend about $400,000, it's approximately $10 per rider. We're hoping that with the $40,000 incremental, we're going to shoot for a minimum of 4,000 given that model, but we'd like to get, you know, 4 to 10. And then you can do the math off of that. Our net revenue per ticket times that number is what we're hoping to do. That incremental money is not something that, you know, if our budget was flush, you know, it would be, you know, someone could argue that it's, you know, it was fluff or not needed.